Hey, what's going on YouTube? It's Ivan here. Just wanted to show you how you can add your own animations to your ClickFunnels page. So let's jump right in. So I'm going to go to edit page. And as you can see, I even left everything just the way it was. So the headline, the buttons, everything there is completely untouched. All right. So just to show you what this page looks like without animations, you scroll down here, as you can see, it's not too engaging. So in my opinion, and in my experience, when there's kind of a bit more animations on your page, then that engages the audience a bit more. It kind of, you know, your reflexes are active when you see something moving, right? And you become a bit more alert. So that's exactly what the point of animations really is, at least for me. That's the benefit I see in it, all right? So let me show you how you can do that. So animations work on anything. They can work on video, they can work on text, they can work on pictures, and even, you know, entire sections. So for example, let's say you want, let's start off just here at the very top. Let's say you want to have this entire section kind of pop in, okay? So there's two types really of animations. One is something called time delay. One is animation for style. So time delay is these things are really similar. The only difference is under time delay, as you can see, there's not many options. It's only fade in or fade in with scale. Whereas for this one, there's a bit more. So when you click on page load, for example, you have six options, okay? So let's go over really this animation for style, these options instead. So you have two options, okay? Let's start with that. You have on scroll and you have on page load. So if you click on page load and you click here the delay in milliseconds, as soon as your page loads, after the certain period of time specified in there, after that time period passes, the picture that you selected, it will come in, okay? Whereas if you click on scroll, the only time your page will come in is as you scroll down. So regardless of when the page loaded or if your page was there for 5 hours, as soon as you scroll, only then your page will come in, okay? So that's why on scroll is really useful, because you don't know how long the person's going to stay on a particular point, right? So just to show you an example, let's say on page load, let's click from, for example, fade in, and let's say we want it to be in 2 seconds. So this is in milliseconds, okay? So there's 1,000 milliseconds in 1 second, so just keep that in mind. So if we wanted 2 seconds, I'm going to click 2,000 here, click save. So let's click preview. So here's what it's going to look like. So you should see in 2 seconds, the thing should fade in, okay? So that's basically what the animation looks like. So you have fade in option, where it just kind of pops up entirely after a certain time period. You have fade with scale, where it starts small and then grows, expands. You have fade from left, where the picture just comes in from your left side. You have fade from right, where it comes in from your right. You have fade from top, where the picture comes from the top, and fade from bottom, where it really comes quickly from the bottom. So for example, let's say you want to do fade from right on page load, just to show you what it looks like. Click preview. Boom. Okay, it came from the right. So if I click on scroll though, it's going to be a bit different, because now it won't load until I scroll. And you'd have to scroll several times, okay? So it's lagging behind a bit as well. Let me just try that one more time. Shouldn't have taken that long. Okay. So there may be a little glitch here, because it's so far up and there's not much you can scroll up to, right? So maybe a little glitch there. So what I find effective and what I find looks nice is when you have, for example, text and a picture, and you want them to both come in and meet in the middle, okay? So the way you would do that is you wouldn't click the whole section, you would click each particular element that you want to come in. So for example, you don't want to click the blue one, right? You don't want to click the blue gear icon, because this is going to include everything. So if you want to make an animation for different parts of a column, you want to click on the different elements of it. You don't want to click on the blue one, okay? So I'm going to click on this yellow or this orange gear icon here. Oh, give me a hard time. Now, if you can't catch it, right, all you have to do is click elements here and then just kind of scroll down to the section so that it highlights the section that you want to animate. So in this case, it's going to be, let's see, that's not being very friendly today. All right, so here, so I think it's, yeah, so there, so it's highlighting the image and then the headline, okay? So, okay, sure, let's start with the image. So I'll click the image here, And then I will scroll down. Okay, so here you want to go down to where it says animation for style. So let's click, let's make it on scroll. Okay, because like we mentioned earlier on page load, you don't know how long the person's going to stay at the top page. So may not be effective if they stay on there for you know, longer than whatever you specified. And let's make this fade from left. The delay now, because it's on scroll, the longer the delay here is, I think the more ineffective it is, because if you scroll down and your delay is like 5 seconds, then as you scroll, they won't see anything until they're 5 seconds in, okay? So people may think that, hey, there's nothing here. So really what I do is I just actually just put zero there. So that means as soon as I scroll, that part's gonna come in, okay? And this part's gonna fade from left. So I'll just save that. Click journey here. Oh, again, okay. So there, I was able to catch the icon that time. So then I'll click animation, I'll click on scroll again, and I'm gonna click fade from right. Again, I'm gonna go zero, click save. Click this orange one here, all right. Well, again, I'll scroll down to the bottom, click on scroll, and fade from right, and again, I'll press zero. So I'm gonna click save, and let's see what this part is going to look like under preview, okay. So here's this one, we didn't change anything, so maybe we should make this one come in as the page loads. And then for this one, boom, okay. So it came in together. There was a bit of a delay, as you may have noticed, and that is because as you scroll down, the top, the part where it says the journey, it's higher than the text itself, right? So it will come up a bit sooner. So if you really want them to come on at the same time, then maybe add a little delay this part. You know, you'll have to play around with that. So maybe make it 300 milliseconds, 500 milliseconds. Just time it enough so that it comes in as soon as this part, as soon as this text comes in, okay? So that's something you'll have to play around with. I mean, here we can even try it out now, right? So for example, if, as you may have noticed, the first time the journey came in before the text. So if I want to make them come in at the same time, maybe I'll make this, you know, let's see what happens if I make this 500. Click save, preview. Okay, so that one was much closer. Okay, so you'll have to find and then sync them in time accordingly. So let's just see what the rest of this is gonna look like. So I'll click, no, let's do the rest of it here. And again, you can do whatever you want. You can make it on page load, you can make it on scroll, and you can also make it come in fade with scale, where the text will gradually become bigger. Well, it'll become bigger really fast. You won't even see it, but that's basically the mechanics behind it. It can fade in, so it can just appear. Fade from left, fade from right, top or bottom, okay? But for the purpose of this, we're just making all the text come from the right and all the pictures come from the left, okay? So that's why I'm clicking fade from right for the text part, and I will make this zero. And then I'll do the same for all the elements here. So I'll click there, I'm gonna scroll down all the way to the bottom. There it says no animation, I'm gonna click on scroll, I'm gonna say fade from right, I'll make that zero. And then for this picture, I'll do the same thing, but in this case, I'll do fade from left, okay? So that they both come in together at the same time. So on scroll, I'll say fade from left, zero, okay? Now I'll save my work, and then let's do this one more time. Click the orange gear icon for the headline. Click on scroll, fade from right, zero. Oops. Not my lucky day. Let's try this again. All right, on scroll, fade from right, zero. And the picture, let's do this from the left and let's see what this is gonna look like. Zero, okay. You know what, just to make things a bit more interesting, let's just make this whole thing come in maybe from top. You know what, I'm gonna call this, it's giving me a hard time. Let's see, so I'll just click this thing and I'll make this one, I'll make the animation on scroll, but I'll make it come from, let's make it come from bottom, okay, and I'll make it zero again. So as soon as you scroll down, this part will come up from the bottom really fast, okay? And let's make this part come from top, just to show how it goes. So I'll click on scroll, feed from top, 0 again. Okay, all right. You know what, one more thing let me just quickly do here. I'll just change this and I'll make it instead of on scroll, because as you noticed, it didn't quite work very well. I'll make it on page load. So on page load, I'll make it, 1 second, so 1,000 milliseconds. And I'll make it, maybe I'll make it feed from bottom as well. All right, so let's see what our work has yielded for us. So there you go, as you saw, it just came up from the bottom. That's our animation. We're gonna scroll down, boom. These guys came in, this one came from the bottom, and that came from the top, okay? So there you go. That's how you add animations, guys. So if you have any questions, let me know down below. Like, comment, subscribe. I'll be doing more how-to videos for you guys, and now you know how to do animations. Thanks for watching, and until next time.